drill an inch and a quarter hole in the top of the body block. This gives me a way to attach it to the lathe and provides a mortise that can use to install the top. Here's the body block in the rough terrain of the Snowman. Choose it to a final screen and have them take it. I'm using a custom template which allows me to consistently mark the grooves for the waist and neck areas of the body. The neck and waist grooves are being rough formed here. Each is cut to a specific depth and width and will be tweaked shortly. Now I'm knocking down the bottom and neck sections to rough the animal. These will also be refined. Thank you. me that it's starting to look a bit like a top hat. This is the most creative part of making my snowman, which feels completely unique in every top hat I've ever turned. I use the saw to cut the rough hat blank from the big cylinder. It could be turned off, but I feel this is just a bit safer rather than reaching over the large block to try to catch the piece as it flies off. Okay, I've mounted the rough top hat blank by the tenon that was cut earlier, and now I'm going to be ready to complete turning the piece to its final shape. Spring and friction to burn in a couple black lines to highlight the hat kind of area. More sanding. You can notice how well my dust collection system sucks the dust from the area. Finally, there's a paste to remove any small scratches left by the sanding process. This also adds a little oil and wax to the paint, bringing out the gorgeous color in the room. And here it is, the finished top, ready to be paired with a snowman. Some of their hats glued on, and notice the individual tilt to the snowman's hats.